BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
For the 30th annual Boscov's Berks Jazz Fest, presented by the Berks Arts Council, March 27th through April 5th. It's one of the most exciting festivals in the world, featuring top-name traditional, contemporary, and blues performers. Celebrate the 30th with 10 musical days of concerts, jams, and more. Tickets on sale now. For the latest artist, venue, and scheduling info, and for tickets, check out berksjazzfest.com.
Well, hi, everybody. I'm Mike Anderson. I'm sort of your guest host tonight for the Berks Arts Council show. And as you can see by the video that we just showed, we have something exciting to talk about. The 30th anniversary of the Boscov's Berks Jazz Fest. It's coming up soon, and we have a couple of guests here to talk about it. We have Keith Mooney here from the Berks Arts Council.
How's everybody doing?
And John Ernesto, from general manager of the Berks Jazz Fest for many years. And we have a lot to talk about as far as performers that are going to be here, when they're going to be here, and some of the exciting things that are happening. John, what do you...
Well, there's a lot going on. I mean, it's the most challenging thing is March 2nd, and I mean, you're 25 days away from the start of the festival. So there's a lot of preparation work going on, and a lot of excitement, and I think this 30th anniversary festival is going to be very special, and everybody, the whole team is working very hard to... get ready, and the Arts Council staff, and obviously Mike—he's representing the Berks Horns tonight, but he does a whole lot more than that. He's very involved in the marketing. That video that you saw was created by Mike. So, bottom line is everybody's working together to have a tremendous celebration of our 30th annual festival.
And John, you've been with the fest for many years, yet since the beginning in one capacity or another, and as general manager for the past...
Since 1994.
Wow.
Yeah.
And Keith, your involvement with the Arts Council, what is it you can bring to the table here tonight?
As John said, everybody's working together right now as a cohesive team. I can tell you the festival is selling well right now, so it's going to be well attended. As always, we're tracking to have one of the best years ever. So hopefully, if you don't have tickets to the shows that you want to see, get out there and get them as soon as possible, because you don't want to be disappointed if your show is sold out.
Yeah. And you're one of the MCs, announcers,
yes,
for many of the shows. So
yes,
you got to,
yeah,
come out to see Keith, for sure.
Keith is a very active board member, and we, right, appreciate that. You know, the festival kicks off on Friday, the 27th, with Chris Bode. We're excited about having Chris back at the festival. He played with us many years ago when he was just cutting his teeth in the business. And then we have our 30th anniversary concert on Saturday night at the Santander Performing Arts Center, hosted by Rick Braun. And that show is going to be a special one. It's an all-star show featuring Peter White, Mindy Hebert, Brian Bromberg, Larry Braggs,
Nick
Colleone, and the Berks Horns. And it's going to be a real nice show that Rick's putting together. And the nice thing about it, in the middle of the program, at some point we're going to do a memoriam remembrance of all the headliners who played the festival since 1991 who are no longer with us. So that's going to be a nice touch. We're excited about that.
Not only the headliners, but also some of the local talent.
A lot of the local people like Frank Scott, Craig Fisher, Wes Fisher, right, who were instrumental in the beginning of this in 1991.
We have a lot of good local talent involved with it this year, not only with Get Jazz Ed program, there's a lot of people playing in the fest, like Eric Koala, who has been a member of the all-star orchestras.
Yeah, he came up through our education program. Yeah, so yeah.
There's a lot of people that have made it through the 30 years.
Yeah, and one of the nice things we have this year, we're able to bring back Bailiffelec and the Flecktones. The Flecktones, when they first started, they're actually celebrating their 30th anniversary this year, too.
Nice.
And they played actually the second band show, I believe it was.
No, it was the first.
Was it the first? I remember the people at MedEd did an ad in the paper called, "Who the heck is Bailiffelec?" Well, the Flecktones have gone on to great things, and so they're coming back. There's to be their 8th performance at the festival, and it's back Bayless 10th because he was here a couple times without the Flecktones.
That's right.
And I believe Victor was here on his own.
Oh yeah, Victor's been here on his own. Yeah, Future Man did a workshop one time. So
well, and this coagulation of the musicians is the original band.
Yeah, Howard Levy's
Howard
back
Levy's
with us.
Back
yeah,
with him, yeah.
So we're excited. In fact, we have a video. The Flecktones' recent live performance. So let's just check that out.
Wow, that's great. That's great. We were kind of joking a little bit before we did the studio is what is jazz? But there's just another form of jazz there. And we were talking about also Howard Levy playing on this job again, playing harmonica here. He was called the man with two brains because he also plays keyboard while he's doing that. And, you know, it's a two different ways of thinking. So it's great to see him back on the fest again.
Yeah, Howard. Actually, Howard played the genesis of the Thursday Night All-Star Jam, which is now the Chuck Loeb Memorial All-Star Jam, started at the Peanut Bar.
Yeah, that's right.
One night, and people familiar with the Peanut Bar in that cubby hole there where they have live music, we had Rick Braun, Howard Levy, there were several of my, I don't know, it was Peter White, it was guitar players. I mean, we had all these people, and the place was packed. And I said, we got to find a home for this. I think we can make some money with it alive.
Well, it's funny, with the Berks Horns, Rob Diener is our trumpet player, and he was at that event, and he was mesmerized by seeing Rick Braun play trumpet, and that kind of got him excited about playing jazz. You know,
that's good.
Rob was a classical player up to that point. Yeah. So, yeah, there's a lot of history. There's a lot of local history.
That's right. Yeah. And speaking of local stuff, one of the shows that we're really excited about this year is the Reading Pops Orchestra celebrating the spirit of Django Reinhardt. It's going to be the full orchestra, and we put together an amazing group of musicians to be part of this. Julien Lepro, who's a master accordion player from France, who now lives in New York. Frank Vignola, Vinnie Raniola, great guitars. And we have Josh Taylor, who's the brains behind the Hot Club of Reading, and Tom Stroman on saxophone. And they're playing with the Pops Orchestra. And it's going to be an exciting program for several reasons. Number one, we now are dedicating that concert to the memory of Jim Connors from Connors Investors. Jim was one of the leading business proponents, supporters of the festival in the early days, worked with us to get the business community involved, and he loved the jazz festival, he loved jazz, and you know, he was faithfully supporting this event right up to the day he passed. So we are dedicating this program to Jim Connors. And also, Julien Lepro has written a brand new concerto, 30-minute piece that's going to close out the concert, and it's dedicated to the 30th anniversary, Django Reinhardt's 110th birthday, and to Jim Connors.
Yeah, I think we have a little promo to.
Yeah, we have a promo. To kind of give people an idea of what's going on. Here's a little promo on the Pops.
The 30th Annual Boscov's Berks Jazz Fest presents Reading Pops celebrates the spirit of Django Reinhardt on Saturday, March 28th, 7 p.m. at the Miller Center for the Arts. The evening features an all-star ensemble performing with the Pops, including Julien Lepro, Frank Vignola, Vinnie Raniola, Tom Stroman, and Reading's own Josh Taylor. It's dedicated to the memory of Jim Connors, a special friend of the fest, and will be highlighted by the debut of a new musical concerto composed by accordionist Lepro and dedicated to Jim.
So that show is on Saturday, March the 28th at the Miller Center at 7:30. And it's going to be a special night. And I hope folks who support the Pops and also people who knew Jim Connors come out and help us celebrate Jim's memory through this collaboration. I talked to Will Rapp, the conductor of the Pops, and to Frank Vignola last week, and they both seen Julien's score, and they said it's amazing. They were all anxious to play it, so it's going to be a fun night and a great concert.
Well, that's a different type of jazz, as we talked about.
Absolutely.
Not only do we have traditional jazz, smooth jazz, we have the blues a lot.
A lot of blues.
A lot of blues.
And that's right up Keith's alley.
Oh yeah, he
that's
the
a
blues,
sweet spot.
Huh? Yeah.
We got a lot of blues this year, and we have one of the greatest blues guitarists of our day today playing on Saturday, April 4th. We have Tab Benoit. Tab has a tight trio. It's Tab, his bass player, and a drummer. He uses no special effects pedals. Everything is speed and accuracy. That's the way he was taught, and that's the way he believes guitar should be played. He hails from Houma, Louisiana, and he's an incredible guitarist. So I encourage you to get out and see Tab, as well as Kenny Neal the week before,
right.
Who also hails from Louisiana. Kenny's from New Orleans, Louisiana, and hails from a musical family of 11 brothers and sisters, all of whom are blues musicians.
Right.
We have Billy Price playing too at one of the events.
He's Friday night. He's the second Friday, April the 3rd.
And that's Blues at the Inn, right?
Yep, correct. Billy Price and his Charm City Rhythm Band. Yeah. And then we also have on Wednesday night, we have Craig Thatcher from Lehigh Valley and his band doing their real popular Eric Clapton retrospective. So there's definitely a nice blues thread, which is kind of sets up for our Reading Blues Fest later this year.
Yeah. We have a spot of Tad.
Yeah, we have some performance of Tad Benoit.
The song I was telling y'all about not just a few minutes ago. The key of E.
Yeah.
E. Take it to the E. E is the lowest key that you can play on a guitar. It's a song that everybody knows, but they don't necessarily know it this way.
A lot of blues coming, and there's something for just about everybody at the 30th anniversary of the Boscov's Berks Jazz Fest. We've got some traditional stuff too. We talk about the traditional jazz and some big band things, and we have a lot of artists coming in from all over the world playing. But something has developed for that. John, you want to talk about that?
Yeah, we started the Berks Bop night. I guess it might have been 8 years ago or so, with Chuck Loeb. We wanted to have the contemporary jazz artists, give them an opportunity to stretch and have some fun some night and just play bop music. So we created the Berks Bop Night, and it caught on, and people really liked it. And we did it on Wednesday night, so it's become Wednesday is traditionally Berks Bop Night. At our 25th anniversary, Chuck and I put our heads together, and we created the Berks Bop Big Band, and we did
it's
that.
Easy for you to say.
Yeah. And everyone loved it. It was a lot of fun. The musicians had a blast. So for our 30th anniversary, unfortunately, Chuck's no longer with us, as you know. But Eric Marienthal and Andrew New stepped up, and they're going to be musical directors for the Berks Bop Big Band, the 30th anniversary. And that's going to be fun. That's going to be at the Doubletree on April the 1st.
That's in the Grand Ballroom.
In the Grand Ballroom. Mm-hmm. And the Berks High School All-Star Band is going to open for them.
Nice.
So that's nice. So, but the great musicians, going to be a full big band with, you know, the traditional guys like Rick Braun, Gerald Albright, Everett Harp, Jeff Lorber. I'm going to miss somebody, but anyways, the bottom and Brian Bromberg.
Brian Bromberg.
They'll part of the big band, and then Andrew put together some great regional players to fill it out. So, and then that's, that sets up, the next night is the Chuck Loeb Memorial All-Star Jam at the Doubletree, and that's become a tradition. We renamed it in Chuck's memory last year, and
that started out the peanut bar.
Like we mentioned, years ago, and it's come a long way since then. So now we sit, pack the ballroom at the Doubletree on a Thursday night. So.
Plus, there's some all-star jams on the Gerald Veasley's jams, midnight jams.
Yeah, Gerald Veasley's hosting his midnight jams at the Inner Reading both weekends, Friday and Saturday, and they're. I have to admit, I don't get to see a lot of those, but I get to see maybe one or two during the, but they're great. People love them, and they start a little before Gerald gets them going before midnight, and then it gets rolling and it ends at 1:30. So it's 90 minutes of wee hour of the morning music. So
I think a lot of the artists talk about the fact that they get to play with people they don't normally get to play with on these.
Absolutely, yeah.
And I was going to say, the Midnight Jam, for those of you who are looking to get the bang for your buck, is a way to see a lot of our artists at one time. And normally what they do is they'll play some contemporary music that's familiar to most of the artists, and then they'll all take turns stretching out over the course of the tune.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so that's a good way to experience the festival.
Yeah, and in a midnight jam, you may end up having Tab Van Wass sit in with Gerald Veasley. I mean, they're going to be in the same hotel, so you hope that kind of synergy spontaneity comes together.
We had Slam Allen a few years ago. Yeah. Blues guys sat in and started doing some James Brown. With the jazz guys, and
it's fun. And you have some unusual things, too, with Dean Brown doing the Summer of Love Evolution.
This is going to be a great show. It's Friday, April the 3rd at the Miller Center, and it's called Dean Brown's Summer of Love Evolution. It's an amazing band. Randy Brecker, Eric Marienthal, Keith Carlock, the drummer for Steely Dan, Jim Beard, who's the piano player for Steely Dan, Honey DeRochelle, she's a great R&B singer from the West Coast. The Berks horns are in it, and Mino Sunuli. The whole concept is Dean has taken music from 1968 to 1972, the Summer of Love music, and put arrangements together of all this stuff.
You're going to hear a little bit different.
You're going to hear Aquarius and Django in a mashup. Yeah. You're going to hear Steppenwolf. You're going to hear Beatles.
The Beatles, yeah.
And a lot of great stuff. So. It's
but with a different spin to it.
With a different spin, it's a different spin. So that's what makes the festival special. You know, those kind of things.
In fact, when we were talking about the opening act, we've had Manhattan Transfer. Weren't they an opening act at one point?
Sure. Yeah, they opened the festival.
We have somebody from that
Janice
group.
Janice Siegel's coming to the festival herself. She's one of the founding members, and she's going to do a duo show at the WCR Center for the Arts on Sunday, March the 29th at 3 o'clock. And she has John DeMartino on piano vocal. It's going to be a great show in a very perfect acoustic room. So, and we have some video of Janice doing some of her duo work. And let's check it out.
Neath the stars at bazaars, often I've had to caress men. $5 or $10 then I'd collect from all those yes men. Don't be sad, I must add, that they meant no more than chessmen. Darling, can't you see? Was for charity. Though these lips have made slips, it was never really serious. Who'd have thought I'd be brought to a state that's so delirious? Could cry salty tears. Where what a break. For heaven's sake, how long has this been going on?
Well, it's great to see you. But let's wrap this up and talk about what the 30th means to everybody here.
To me, it means another great year of music with the Berks Arts Council. I'm looking forward to several shows. We saw Tab Benoit, the Gerald Veasley show where they're doing the Nina Simone, the music of Nina Simone is going to be a great show.
Yeah.
So I'm looking forward to a lot of it, and I get to host a lot of those shows, so yeah. I'm happy about that.
I'm excited about the 30th. I have to admit, I never dreamt it. You know, Mike's been involved every year also, and none of us ever dreamt we would be doing this 30 years since the first one. And you know, it's a great event for our community, and it makes all the community wins. So all the hard work that everyone puts into it makes it all worthwhile.
And the Arts Council's been involved since day one.
Yeah, it started by the Arts Council, and it's all good. So I got my family's grown up with the Jazz Fest. I
had my, say hello to
yeah. Well, my one daughter Kate, birthday is always in March, so she celebrated a lot of her birthdays at the Jazz Fest. So now we have four grandkids who are kind of learning about the music, so it's kind of cool, you know. And
get them to go on to the website.
McKenna, Maddie, Owen, and Tanner—they call me Jazzy John. So,
there you go.
It's been a great journey.
Everything is on the website as far as the schedule, and there are so many acts that you should check up on. We didn't mention not even half of them.
I know there's so much music. There's something for everybody, different styles, and. Go to our Facebook page. We post videos of all the musicians talking about their shows. And
BerksJazzFest.com is the web page. And
don't forget at the Santander box office, you can get tickets. And you don't have to pay the Ticketmaster fees if you buy in person.
Okay. That's a good thing.
That's a good thing. So thank you. Thank you for watching. And we hope to see you at our 30th anniversary of one of the greatest events in this area.
Thank you.
The 30th annual Boscov's Berks Jazz Fest presents Reading Pop celebrates the spirit of Django Reinhardt on Saturday, March 20.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.